was an important game for Bangalore, and Virat has been the master of chases in T20 this year. He has proven time and again that he can chase down any target, whatever the conditions, whatever the format. Now one can say that he was helped by Shane Watson at the other end, who chipped in the good knock, 38 if I'm not wrong, but it was all down to him. I would also blame Dhoni to an extent, simply because he didn't bowl Ravi Ashwin. Apart from that one over from your best spinner just doesn't make any sense, no matter what logic you put forth. He went for 7 runs in that one over, and that was it. And Virat Kohli could pace his innings just the way he wanted. He targeted specific bowlers at specific times. He got down the run rate according to his the way he wanted, when he wanted, and it was a thoroughly deserved win for Bangalore. Puts more pressure on Dhoni and Pune, because now we are inching towards the playoffs deadline, and if you start losing now, there is no way back for you. Best batsman, there are a few candidates who come pretty close to him, but yes, specifically if we talk about chases, Shane Watson himself said Virat is probably the greatest chaser of all time, and it's a pretty fair assessment, because the way he assesses a match situation, target, is just totally different. Things fall into place just the way he wants. He manipulates the game on his own terms, which is incredible to watch, because he dictates the terms and everything goes around that, and you have to be incredibly confident about your own game and be able to execute what you set out to do, which very few batsmen have been able to do, and especially in T20 games where the pressure is that much more, two dot balls and it gets to your head. For him to continuously get such wins in such pressure games shows what an exceptional talent he is. But the best batsman, I would still say guys like Kane Williamson and Joe Root can match him shot for shot across conditions. It was a strange game actually. Delhi Daredevils were in with a pretty decent shout. They had a good opening partnership. Quinton de Kock and Samson batting well, but while Punjab bowlers were good, they just seemed to lose their way out of nowhere. And you look at when you looked at the Daredevils dugout, you saw Rahul Dravid just sitting there and with this incredulous look on his face. You just couldn't get why were the Daredevils losing their way. There was nothing special happening out there. They could have easily sealed the game but just by taking ones and twos. It was not a very huge asking rate. One thing maybe that didn't go their way, and it hasn't gone their way for quite some time, is the hitting of Brathwaite. He hasn't delivered as expected so far, and probably that's why. But we can't blame it on just one batsman. For me, Daredevils should have won that one, but Punjab has shown that they have enough fight in them, and nothing's over as yet in this IPL. Pretty much still open, and it really makes it interesting going towards the end of the group stage.